Good evening. Let's begin with the analysis as per our regular setup. And we're going to analyze the market since it is closed now. We're starting a new video series where we are going to be naming them on the basis of the day. So this is day one with the start of the new financial year. And let's see how we progress over time. So we will start with Nifty. And if you've been following the previous videos, as we were expecting, today we have a reversal signal on the Nifty daily chart, which is a gravestone doji. Okay, so what I'm expecting is the start of a corrective move. Obviously, the first level is 23.6%, but the breakout which happened was at 11,126. So there could be a pullback till about 11,156. To 11,025, which is basically the support zone between 50 and 61.8% on the daily chart using Fibonacci retracement. Okay, so that's the expectation. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if tomorrow the market moves up to test the high again and then comes back bearish. Now, if you check, the previous high is not yet tested. Price are not touched the previous high, but did touch the previous resistance. Okay, so let's see how the market plays out tomorrow, but seems like we are now starting getting into a pullback for Nifty. And similar situation in Bank Nifty. We have a bearish candle. The levels, if you want to check, we again use the Fibonacci retracement tool. We are starting from 26599 as this was the starting point of the wave. So here our pullback area would be the previous support again. So this is again between 50 and 61.8%. So you can expect a pullback between 28623 to 28154. Okay, now moving on to some of the stocks which you guys wanted us to analyze. We'll start with Hindalco. As you can see, the market has been bearish. The highs are getting lower and the lows are also getting higher. However, we have a recent high breakout in today's candle. Okay, so now we're going to put the 200-day moving average. And once we do that, you can see that it has touched the 200, which is basically the resistance. Now, I would be bullish on this after I see a body dominating close above today's high, or basically above the 200-day moving average, because there is a possibility that we could have a further downward move starting from here as we are still in the downtrend. But if this turns out to be a bottom, then you will see a breakout of 200-day moving average first and then 228. Okay, so we are at a deciding point. Tomorrow's candle or the next couple of days will make a difference. Let's see how the market plays out. We would not be able to say much unless we see a breakout of this resistance. Chances are that it would continue to fall down because Nifty also is showing signs of a pullback. So that would add to this. But then you cannot be sure unless you see the closing tomorrow. Moving to Bata Industries. Again, a sign of reversal here. But then if you look at just this small move, it has done almost a 50% or a 38.2% retracement. So depends, but we haven't seen a retracement in a while. This could be a start of a retracement also. I would not buy at the current price. If you haven't bought, I'd wait for a better price to buy unless I see the market starting to break the high. Maybe a 61% pullback, maybe 50%, that we'll have to wait and watch. But anyway, this is not a good price to buy at the current price. Though people who are playing in futures can short with a target of 1348. it looks like a 1:1 risk to reward. Reliance, on the other hand, is doing quite well. As you can see on the weekly chart, we are making an all-time high. So there is no resistance on top yet. And if you were to check on the basis of Fibonacci inversion, we have reached 161.8. So we might see a pullback or we might see a continuation on the uptrend. That depends tomorrow. This move has hit the target. So chances are that we can see certain pullback on this stock as well. Okay, let's see what the prices are, what the levels are. This is the previous support, which is between 50 and 38.2. So since Reliance looks strongly bullish, I wouldn't be surprised if we have a pullback till 1332 and then a continuation of the upward move. Although today's candle is bullish, but then if you see, it does have a slight spike. Okay, so to get it clearer, if we check the 4 hourly chart, we have an indecision here and support at 23.6. So we'll have to wait and watch. If you are looking to buy, a good price to buy would be around 38.2%. Okay, JK Tyres, if you see, we have the swings. Looks like the market is bottoming out. We have a higher swing low, but we haven't broken the swing high yet. And price is still below the 200-day moving average. So there's a possibility we could test this level of 106. And for the trend to actually change, Now, a breakout of 99 also would indicate a change of trend. Then we'll have to see what happens at the resistance of 106. Okay. Currently, buying intraday would make sense as long as you are targeting only about 99. Okay. Once you reach this high, then you'll have to decide whether you'd like to hold on to your trade or not. But up till 100 or 99.85, we are still bullish. ITC, on the other hand, if you see, this is a double top. Price tested the previous high, made a new high, but did not close above the previous high. Okay, and now yesterday, which was basically Friday, we had a bearish candle, a dark cloud cover. Today, again, indication that we are now looking for a certain pullback. Okay, let's check the lower time frames to get a better understanding. ITC is more of a short as of now with a target of this recent support. And if you were to look at the retracement levels, now I'm starting the wave Fibonacci level from here because this is the starting point of the recent wave. 38.2 seemed like a good support area, but 200 moving average on the 4 hourly chart is between 50 and 61.8. So we'll have to see. Now, it all depends how much correction Nifty makes. Mostly, we are entering into a pullback phase right now. So, shorting would be a better option in ITC than buying. Now, if you see these three candles, okay, the same price has been tested multiple number of times. This itself is a trading system. A lot of traders I know trade only on this, which means that when a certain high gets tested multiple times, they try to trade on the opposite side. So as soon as you see price breaking 296.5, you could be targeting 291. Now moving on to Axis Bank, just like we were expecting, we are getting a better price, which means today's candle is showing signs of correction. So if you were looking to buy an Axis Bank, a good buying price would be 734, which is basically the previous support area, and 50% Fibonacci support as well. Okay, that's all for now. Let's see how the market plays out tomorrow and continue our discussion tomorrow. Thank you.